Hi everybody, and thanks for joining our talk on SpeedKit, a polyglot and GDPR-compliant approach for caching personalized content. I'm Wolle from the German company Backend, and today I'll be talking about our software as a service that we built for accelerating e-commerce and other websites. So let's get started. Hello? Yeah, presentation's loading. Just a second. Should be ready, like, now. Ah, there you go. Okay, that was a pretty lame joke, I admit it, but it serves a purpose. Namely, illustrating that nobody really likes waiting. And everybody surfs around 3.5 hours every day and waits 20 minutes of those 3.5 hours just for stuff to happen. That's annoying and costs as much as 1 year over the course of your entire life. And that's not only annoying, it's also a real business problem. So Amazon famously said that 100 milliseconds of lost page load time cost them about 1% of conversion rate. So at their size, that's about $1 billion every year. Conversely, Zalando, the German Amazon for shoes, found that accelerating their website by 100 milliseconds brought about 0.7% of revenue per session, and Walmart similarly found that 100 milliseconds of faster page loads bring them 1% in overall revenue. And the reason why page speed plays such an important role for revenue is that it also is an important driver of user satisfaction. So studies found that everything regarding the user interface delay up until 100 milliseconds is perceived as instant, and everything up until 300 milliseconds is still very good. Everything until 1 second is quite okay, but if you go beyond that, people just start thinking about something else. You know, there's a mental context switch, and eventually people just drop out of what they're currently doing. So if you have an online business, your goal should be stay under 1000 milliseconds to keep the user's attention. And it also means that page speed is money if your business is in the internet. This problem is more relevant today than ever before because due to the global pandemic, currently life is basically taking place online and overall traffic increases significantly. And at the same time, we're experiencing severe drops in web speed all over the world. But even though COVID-19 may make the situation worse, the basic problems are the same as always. So first, we have backend processing for assembling data and rendering an HTML in the server, and then transferring that to the client. That may take a while if the server and the client are far apart. And even if the data arrives fast, the client still has to render everything, which may also take its sweet time. We at Backend have made it our mission to resolve these bottlenecks. We're a research-based spin-off from the University of Hamburg that is centered around caching uncacheable data. And we carry our research into practice through SpeedKit, a software as a service for accelerating e-commerce websites. So let's talk about how SpeedKit works in detail. When a website loads, normally the browser just requests something from the origin server and then waits for the response. With SpeedKit, this is accelerated by a caching infrastructure that not only exploits CDNs, but also the local caches in the browser, so in the user device. And it's different from CDN caching because we also have a smart client proxying within the browser, so a service worker process that can decide whether it's actually necessary to ask the origin or whether the same data can be delivered faster from our caching infrastructure. In doing so, we of course exclude resources that we cannot possibly cache, for example, tracking or ad services. And we always make sure that the data in our caches is synchronized with the original content. And this is basically the main challenge here, and you could break it down to two problems. So first, we have to detect content updates, and then we have to propagate these content changes to the clients. And that's what we'll be talking about on the next slides. So the first challenge is detecting content changes. And we do that via revalidation jobs. And a revalidation job specifies what kind of content should be checked for changes. So for example, you could say, take all the HTML files, and then you can trigger that either manually or via cron jobs. And what this revalidation job here does is it queries all the HTML files that are currently cached, and compares them with the cached version. So you hold the original version from the website against the one we have cached, and only those that have actually changed are invalidated in the CDN. And we also transport that information, and that's the next challenge on the next slide, to the client, so that expiration-based caches, such as the browser cache, are also avoided whenever a resource has changed. To illustrate the second challenge, let's look at a simple example. You have a user visiting a product page, and then the HTML is loaded and delivered through a hierarchy of caches. So now the user sees the HTML and its local browser cache, and the invalidation-based cache, so the CDN, have the HTML with a fixed time to live, say a day or so. But now an hour later, so still within the TTL, a different user buys the product and thereby invalidates the HTML. So now all the data that the other user saw before has become stale. But we can by revalidation detect this update, but we can only invalidate the CDN, and the expiration-based browser cache would still return the stale resource here. To tell the user, so the SpeedKit client proxy basically, that the expiration-based cache has to be avoided, we apply a trick. And the trick is that we store the updated HTML file in a server data structure called the cache sketch. So that's on the bottom right. And then we transport that every 30 seconds by default to all clients, so that before loading a page, the SpeedKit client proxy can make a lookup whether the resource that is to be taken out of the browser cache is actually fresh or not. And if this test determines that the resource should or could be stale, then it's just avoided and the browser cache is not used, but instead the CDN is used. And this gives us delta-atomicity because we know that we never deliver data that is older than 30 seconds. So this shows how we make sure that we never deliver stale content from our caches. But accelerating websites is still challenging because the HTML file, which is pivotal for performance because every other resource is linked in there, is very difficult to accelerate since it's personalized typically. So what we do is we configure SpeedKit in such a way that it knows which portions of the website are personalized. For example, the Hello Customer badge or the number of items in your shopping cart. And then SpeedKit delivers an anonymous version of the website immediately from the caches, so very fast, and in the background loads the personalized version of the website, so for the logged in user, so that we can patch in the personalized portions later. So if you hold that side by side, you see that the anonymous version and the personalized version of the same website typically look very similar. So there's really not much disruption in your user experience if you just say, see the anonymous version first and the personalized version later. But it's really relevant for acceleration. So in a nutshell, we load the anonymous and fast version of a website from the very fast SpeedKit caches and just fetch the personalized information from the original system and patch it in later. GDPR-wise, this is an awesome concept because we do not process any kind of sensitive user information. You know, the patching together is done within the browser, so on the user device, and all that is confidential or private in any way is stored on the original shop system, and still we can accelerate content delivery. And the key enabling technology here is service workers. So with a normal website, the browser tab just fires up a request against the network and then waits for the response. And with SpeedKit, we have the smart client proxy sitting in the middle. So that's a service worker process that intercepts all HTTP requests that are going out and then can decide whether it is actually served, so whether the response is actually served by the requested origin, or for example by the cache, and that as I just explained serves as a mechanism for acceleration, but also can be used to implement offline capability. So it essentially turns your off-the-shelf website into a progressive web app. And one thing that is particularly beneficial here is that SpeedKit can reroute requests to different origins. So usually, for example, if you include third-party libraries in your website, like the Google Analytics or the Facebook SDKs, then these resources are served over cold and slow connections, and that really slows down your website as well. But with SpeedKit, you can just serve these resources over the SpeedKit CDN. You can't do that with any other CDN because they do not hook into the request routing into inside the browser. And another thing that just comes by default here is that we can apply on-the-fly optimizations to resources such as images. So for example, we optimize JPEGs to WebP whenever the browser supports that, and thereby just reduce the payload of served images without compromising the quality. And this is very reliable because more than 90% of all users use browsers that support service workers. And even if you have an old browser that does not support service workers, then the website is served as usual. So you don't really have degrading effects there. It's just better when you have a service worker browser, and it's just the vanilla website experience else. To really get the best possible performance for our customers, we integrated a real user monitoring into SpeedKit so that we can track and monitor performance metrics like the time to first byte or various browser timings, but also user engagement metrics and business KPIs. So if we have an online shop, for example, we configure SpeedKit to know what exactly a conversion is, and then we can tell you whether your user or session conversion rate is going up or not. And we can also monitor all kinds of mistakes and errors that happen, so we can actually improve the quality of the website because we have built-in QA as well there. And what we do here is essentially we do split testing for web performance. And this is a very neat feature because no other CDN solution can actually do that, because CDNs are always only on or off. So you can only compare performance in a before after fashion. But with SpeedKit, you can enable SpeedKit, since it's JavaScript based, for only a portion of all users. And then you can say, okay, let's compare SpeedKit users and normal users at the same time on the website and collect tracking data for both of these user groups, and then compute the uplift performance-wise, but also in session length and other user engagement metrics, business success, and ultimately the money that you are making by using SpeedKit. To illustrate the gains of our approach, let's look at a few customer examples. On the left, you always see the vanilla website experience, and on the right, you see the SpeedKit enhanced version. And as you can see here, for Bauer.de, which is a large German e-commerce retailer, it's a pretty clear win for SpeedKit there. If you look at the numbers, it's also clear that SpeedKit provides a significant uplift, moving the median time until the first contentful paint from above 2 seconds to 1.3 seconds. As another example, here's the German version of Decathlon, which is the world's largest sports online retailer. And we also provide a significant performance uplift there. Here we visualized the first paint performance in a different way, namely the way that Google uses in the Chrome user experience report. And you also see that the fast experience, so below 1 second, is significantly more often achieved with SpeedKit than with the vanilla website. Yeah, and lastly, here is another customer of ours, Stylefile. And as you can see, if you hold SpeedKit and the normal version of the website side by side, it's also clear which is faster. And here we compared the business performance of SpeedKit users against the normal users without SpeedKit, and we achieved a significant uplift in both the user-based conversion rate and the average order value. Okay, time to sum everything up. SpeedKit offloads servers because it serves resources from the CDN that would normally be requested from the origin server. Thereby, it reduces latency and improves the overall customer experience. And that concludes our talk. Thanks very much for your attention. As a closing thought, we are publishing ongoing results on the impact of web performance on business success. at speedstudy.info. So if you're interested in what we do, check that out. Otherwise, drop me a line at wolle@backend.com or ask questions now. Thank you.